Hey, welcome back to the homestead, everyone. So today I'm going to be doing a video that's going to be comparing two different trends of thought. The first being how I would prefer to raise my pigs outdoors in wooded pasture areas versus some guys on another YouTube channel who came out with a video on the benefits of raising them indoors. So the channel that we're going to be looking at is That'll Do Farms. They've been a sixth generation pig farmer, so I don't want to take anything and discredit anything that they say, because their experience is 1,000 times more than anything I've been able to produce in the 2 years I've been raising pork out in the woods. So let's take a look at one of the clips from them, and I'll give you my counter to it. All right, let's get going. I grew up at the very end of raising pigs outside. My dad raised pigs outside. We farrowed them in what we call 10-pen farrowing buildings, and then we turned them out in dirt lots that had an electric fence around it, and they rooted, and you fed them in big round feeders, and you fought the rain, and you fought the cold, and all that. So if you put a pig outside, pigs like a temperature very similar to people.
All right, so a quick Google search, trying to find something to support this. Pigs require the same temperatures that humans do. Now, last time I checked, last time I checked, humans don't have the same fat layers that pigs do. Pigs have a very, very thick insulating layer. But looking at the pigs in this video, they're like hairless pink pigs. So to me, those pigs may not be able to withstand the Iowa weather. That's where they're located, in southeastern Iowa, and it does get colder there, so that might be why they have failed raising those types of pigs outside and had a lot of loss during their winters with the cold. Now, if you're talking homestead pigs, if you're talking pasture type pigs, most of them are lard pigs, like the Coon Coon and the IPP we see right here eating. Those are lard pigs. They are hairy pigs. They're not as hairy as Ogre or Mangalista over there, but they are hairy pigs, and as it gets colder, they get more hair, and they also have a very, very thick layer of fat around them. So I'm going to disagree that they need it for to stay warm. I think that they can get by just fine with their current situation. If you throw some hay into a three-sided shelter, they're going to be just fine for that. So that's my counter to that. Let's hear his next tip.
Put a pig outside, the first thing is they're going to get sunburned because their skin is sensitive to that.
So all right, so his next point about pigs getting sunburned, I am not saying that this is not true, but what I will counter that with is, with outdoors in a wooded environment, you could have 100% of the sun blocked at any time. The pigs can actually regulate themselves going in and out. Once again, he's got pink pigs. Those pink pigs are kind of like an albino person. You send them outside and they're gonna get burned. But you know, if the pigs are like, you know, humans, which he says they are, the areas that I have a lot of hair, I don't burn ever, because the hair, even at certain layers, protects that skin. So when you look at pigs, then look at pigs that have a little bit of hair, and you won't have to worry about that. Now, that might not be ideal for everybody. The woods is gonna block that UV. On that same note though, he did say that pigs are like humans, and so I did look up, you know, pigs' UV requirements, and pigs absorb vitamin D through the sun, just like humans do. And that's one thing that you'd have to supplement for them in some way, feeding them indoors. Let's go to his next point.
Problem with all that is one, if you want to destroy a piece of ground, turn a herd of hogs out there, because they'll turn it over like a power shovel. A pig is a power shovel on four legs, and they will naturally just root that ground and root that ground. And you want to see erosion and the soil wash away, put a bunch of pigs outside. It's not a very environmentally friendly way
to take care of your land.
All right, in his next point, he brought up how destructive pigs are to the ground and the land and how they will just root up and create a moonscape. And I will agree with him on that. So last year we let our hogs out into the pig pen, my kids' show hogs. And those show hogs, within a matter of a week, had completely uprooted the entire landscape behind us. On that note though, because they did that after we took them in to get butchered, we actually had our other pigs in another wooded area. We let it kind of grow back and it came back really nice and thick. Probably because they ate it, they tilled it, they probably moved some seeds around. You know, a whole lot of things could have happened. They basically made the growing conditions really well, not to mention their little poopies going down there to fertilize it. So having them root it can actually be a huge benefit. And if you use your pigs properly, like through rotational movements, they're gonna help with your landscape. They're gonna help with some of the control of your area. Because if you have nothing but shrubs and brambles and your pigs go in and clear that up, I'm not as concerned about erosion because now I can get in there and I can manage the land. I can remove trees that I don't want. I can plant cover crops that I'm gonna use to feed the pigs that'll be more self-sustaining in the long run. So to me, the erosion, although if you just completely ignored them might be a problem, I think it's to your benefit to let them manage and clear your own land for you so you can save your time and money and work. Not to mention it feeds them, it's sustainable, and it doesn't cost you anything except for putting up the fencing to get them into your land so that they can clear it. So go with that. His next skip's coming.
The other thing is, when they do that, they root in the soil, they get all kinds of parasites, worms. You would have to constantly put those pigs on wormer because they would be getting parasites and everything else pretty constant.
All right, so for his next point, he said it probably is something that I'll agree with him 100% on, is that parasites and worms and other issues are way more common outside and you have to constantly medicate and do checkups on your pigs when they're outside. The only thing I'm going to say, because overall I'm like 90% in agreement with this, pigs that are indoors can still get those things. Yes, they're more likely, but I think that the pigs are getting them outdoors because they're foraging, they're going through, they're eating more natural things. So the cost to me is definitely a feed savings cost versus having to give them an ivermectin bath every 6 months that doesn't cost me very much. So in the total, yes, I agree with him, but is that a worthy enough reason to not do it? I'm gonna go with no on that. All right.
Naturally are a clean animal. If you look at these pigs, they're pretty clean and they don't wanna lay in manure and they don't wanna roll around in manure. A lot of times they do that when they're hot because they're trying to stay cool. They prefer to stay clean, and if you look at these pens, now we just thinned these out, so the pens are probably a little dirtier than normal, but you'll find they'll have an area where they all want to lay, and they'll have an area that they want to eat and get a drink, and they'll have an area where they all want to crap, and they aren't going to lay where they crap. That whole idea that a pig likes to roll in the mud and that a pig is dirty, and that's why people say that someplace looks like a pigsty. Well, if you're raising pigs outside, it would look like that.
All right, so we just talked about cleanliness. I think cleanliness is a very debatable concept, especially when considering how we're doing wooded pasture, raised pork versus confined indoor. This is actually confined outdoor. So I understand his point that if they are in a confined space, they are going to be forced to, you know, roll around in their filth. When you really open up the area that your pigs are in, like in our wooded area, it's rare to even see pig droppings, let alone finding it to be such a problem that the pigs are having to live in it. So space is probably more key to that than anything. And I think that goes with indoors or outdoors. If you have them in a small enclosure indoors, they're gonna live in their filth. If you have them in a small pen like we have some of our boars in, they're gonna kind of live in their own filth. But if you let them run free in the wooded areas, the filth is gonna be very minimal. If anything, all they're gonna do is maybe walk over it a few weeks later and,
and chop it up as fertilizer for your soil fauna. So I'm gonna disagree with that one. It's more of a space issue than indoor-outdoor issue, all right?
The reason that we built these buildings was for the betterment of the pig, because we couldn't raise pigs in the winter. Your death loss was high. They were sick all the time. They had worms. They didn't grow very well. It was hard to feed them. It's not a sustainable way to do it. A lot of people like to say that that's sustainable farming. That's not sustainable. On a small scale, it's sustainable, but if you're gonna feed the world, you're not gonna do it with pigs in a pasture.
Okay, so the last point, sustainability. I don't even know how to react to that, because indoors has zero sustainability. Like, you have to provide everything for pigs if they're indoors. You have to provide heat to do what you're wanting to do. You have to provide water, you have to provide food, you have to provide the labor to go in and clean it. You have to provide everything inside. Versus outside, you know, especially in the summer months, you just occasionally go out with a scoop of food to supplement what they're not getting from the woods. And that's it. You know, we have creeks so they can go in and get their own water. We have automated water systems. So, like, there's so many things that are sustainable. Like, just walking through areas that the pigs haven't been on, seeing the thousands of acorns and the thousands of black walnuts, the fruit that's falling off of some of the trees. It's just insane how sustainable that is versus putting them in a building. Not to mention the cost of putting them into a building. They had one video, I think it was $1 million for a building like that. That's crazy. That's crazy. That's not realistic for a small scale farmer. I will say this in conclusion, because I think it's very important. These guys made this video showing why it was more sustainable for them to do it this way, to feed the world, okay? So they probably have better grow times than me. They probably have faster, you know, turnaround profit margins on some of their animals. They can get them in and out rotated in the time it would take me to probably raise 4 or 5 pigs. So they also do it in bulk. They have a huge amount of pigs. I think they said like 120 in a paddock, 60 combined into paddocks. That's an insane amount of pigs all at once. We have 13. So it's not a super big comparison. And they did make that comparison in the video. So that's not something that they're disagreeing with us on. And they don't even know I'm making this video. But I do want to say I loved their video. I subscribe to their channel. I recommend you guys do. I'll put it up in the corner here. If you want to look at Big Ag and how their commercial pig farming should look, I think they're top notch. They don't look like they abuse their animals. They have them in wider open areas. They don't look like they're confined in these tiny little pens. So I want to say great job on their operation. And I am jealous of it. But at the same time, I wanted to compare our points so that we could respectfully disagree with each other on the proper pig care. Most people should probably go with you with your 6 generations of farming experience versus mine. I got them 1.5 years ago and I butchered 2 pigs and I haven't even butchered them myself. So a lot goes into this. It's very fun. I'm excited to learn more. I'm gonna learn more from you guys. Hopefully my channel will go over to your channel as well and come see what you guys are all about. We'll catch you on the next video. Bye.